music business, there are always people that can get the parts right, that can play the right notes and that can play the right beats. But you want somebody that's going to be easy to be around also. So one of the things that I liked the most, when it came time for the big rehearsal, we had a lot of music to squeeze into one rehearsal, and he showed up at the same time I did, which is always a good sign. Musicians are kind of notorious for operating on musician time. And he showed up exactly at the same time I did. He was ready to go. He had listened to the things. He played, again, all the right stuff. And he had the right attitude. He was eager to play. He wasn't negative about anything. He wasn't ever confrontational, or he was very good. Show business, there's the show and there's the business. The music part, you learn on the songs, you try to be talented, but that doesn't make a career. The career is being on time and being easy to work with and having the right personality when things are pressurized and treating the person who's in charge the right way. So I would check all those boxes for Jamil. I absolutely plan on calling him again.
This whole thing started for me at a very young age, almost like a pipe dream, you know. You know, you're made to be something great. In your head, you think, you know, one day I'm gonna be an astronaut. One day I'm gonna be a policeman. One day I'm gonna be a doctor. One day I'm gonna be a lawyer, maybe not a lawyer, but you know, one day I'm gonna be something great. And for me, that one thing was music. I always said, one day I'm gonna be tour, I'm gonna play drums, I'm gonna play with all these people. And you know, I would just sit at home and just watch all these people on VHS back then. And you know, I will watch the Wooten Brothers. I will watch Dave Matthews. You know, I will watch, you know, Jeff Coffin. I will watch all these folks that, you know, now that I'm here in Nashville, I've had the opportunity to play for. I grew up in a Christian home, and I will watch a lot of, you know, DC talk like everybody else. You know, I would watch a lot of Carmen, Toby Mac, DC Talk, Dirt Day, McAdory Smith, you know, all those guys. I'll watch those guys a lot. And, you know, growing up with all that music, you know, around my house, it was like, you know, I want to do what those guys do. That's what I want to do. I want to do what they do. So, at a young age, you know, I started putting myself on a path to where I am today. It's funny because as a kid, like, I already had all these wild ideas about how I'm gonna do it when I get there. And I've maintained those ideas. I maintained that drive and that consistency to today. you know, I just try to find ways of how to streamline what I do out here. My playing, my preparedness, my diligence, how I go about interacting with folks out here, you know, in the business. Since I was a kid, I was already thinking about these things. And I don't even know where those ideas come from. You know, where, how did, you know, these ideas at a young age come from, not coming really from music? I mean, I guess I did and I guess I didn't. You know, I wasn't really born into this, you know, extravagant musical family. Music has been in my family, but I wasn't, you know, out of the womb into the drum set. It was not like that for me at all.
Constant is needing somebody is that is what I would like to call a chameleon of player or musician, which basically means somebody who can be very versatile to whether it's a country playing or if it's Afro-Cuban playing or if it's, you know, whatever, rock star playing, you know, that kind of deal. Somebody who can basically kind of blend in with what is being presented to them. And Jamil is definitely a big portion of that. He's able to go from Afro-Cuban playing Latin percussion to being a steady, solid drummer behind the drum kit, that kind of thing. So, you know, I would say versatility.
One word to describe Jamil's playing, I would say exciting. He always brings a level of focus and contributes a level of energy to the stage with his playing. His precision, his research, he does his homework before he gets on stage, and that allows him to contribute on the highest level for those of us that are on stage and for in the crowd. They hear the difference too.
For me, every time somebody books me for an appearance, that's the only thing that matters to me at that one moment. It's extremely important. I treat every single booking like it's the last one that I'm gonna do. Sounds a bit extreme, but I really do. I'll tell you why, because for me, every single appearance that I get booked for, it's an audition that can lead to the next thing. And those things are very important to me, being that a full-time musician out here in this city, trying to make your ends meet as a drummer, it is important to make sure you take every single appearance very serious. So for me, preparation is key, and getting prepared is a very rigorous process for a guy like myself. Being a drummer, you just don't have one thing to bring, you have many things that you have to bring to an appearance. So for sure, it's a long, lengthy process, but it's definitely worth it because for me, the smile of a person that hired me for an appearance after the show saying, hey, Jamil, you did a great job, that's exactly what I want. I want people to feel confident that when they look back during their show, they know, man, that's Jamil Conga back there, and I know that he's taking my gig serious.
He got a following because he's everything that you would want. He's a pro. He has great, you know, feel. His playing is phenomenal. His professionalism is great. You know, when he did the show, I mean, he had a look. He showed up with that. He didn't just show up, you know, looking like he just got done working on the car. You know, so everything about it was right on point. And he knew what you needed. You didn't have to. It was just a connection.
I continued to hire Yamil for several reasons. Number one, I just love him as a guy. He's a great guy. He's a good friend. We've worked with him for years. He's always wonderful to have on the team and just to be around. And he comes so prepared. If I give him material ahead of time, he's got all of it down when he shows up to the rehearsal. And I love how just willing, so willing he is to give you anything you're looking for in the sound, to switch it up, to try something different. He's never offended by anything you ask of him. And I think also, just really, he loves what he does. I love how he's not there just to get the gig done and get out. He just truly has a passion for it. He enjoys playing music.
I would say if you need somebody to bring the heat consistently, time and time again, with passion, with precision, Yamil Conga is your man.
He's dependable, good guy, gonna be punctual, all the stuff you need. He'll give you what you want.
I would say definitely give this guy a shot. He's a great guy. He's a great guy to have in your band. He's a good hang. He's got a great spirit about him and a great presence on stage. He's definitely gonna add to your show. You definitely wanna hire.